XFM News. On point. It's time for the news on XFM. I'm Chris O'Tim. President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni has asked the youth to avoid engaging in any form of hooliganism because they will scare away potential investors. Museveni says affluent business entrepreneurs prefer to invest their wealth in stable countries like Uganda, but if the youth decide to start rioting and burning of tires on the roads, they will be had to by unemployment due to the lack of factories. He made the warning during his meeting with the NRM leaders in Busia district while campaigning there yesterday.
If we can create 5,000 jobs in Mbale in a very short time in the industrial park, why can we not create more jobs with more factories? But in order to do that, we must maintain peace so that we don't frighten these people. Therefore, when you say I am a youth, but I cause trouble because I don't have a job, you are acting against your own interests, because the people who could have helped us create jobs are now not going to come. You will end up being like these countries of the Arab world, Tunisia, Egypt. They caused confusion up to now. Even the little they had collapsed.
Election experts want the ongoing presidential campaigns to be suspended. The demand follows the increased reported deaths of supporters for some of the opposition presidential candidates, arising from the force applied by the security forces when dispersing gatherings for failure to observe the COVID-19 SOPs. Now, Crispin Kahero says the campaigns should be halted until when the new rules are set out to end the deaths of innocent citizens.
The enforcement of COVID-19 prevention standard operating procedures is causing more threats to life than the COVID itself. Let's halt the campaigns and agree on whether indeed we have the capacity and conditions to have a free, fair and credible vote under the circumstances. People's lives are being lost. If we are indeed concerned about Ugandan lives, let's halt these campaigns and agree on new rules of the game before we go back to hit the ground running.
Police is holding a suspected fraudster who allegedly conned over 100 people of their money. The suspect, Winfred Nsubuga Mukalazi, who purported to have owned a company known as Africa Electoral Alliance, had promised his victims jobs and obtained millions of shillings from the unsuspecting public. The spokesperson of the police CIID department, Charles Twine, confirms that they have placed the suspect under quarantine after testing positive for COVID-19 and will be charged in court upon discharge from Nambole.
It's very true. He was arrested yesterday, and at the time of arrest, we had true and known that he's COVID positive. So we arrested him with the utmost care and conveyed him to the police station. We immediately rang our doctors from the Uganda Police Medical Services, who delivered the ambulance that subsequently took him to Nambole for quarantine. We are in constant touch with our medical team at Nambole. We do expect that he recovers from COVID. We shall charge him of obtaining money by false pretense, as well as charging him under Section 171 of the Penal Code, being an act likely to spread an infectious disease.
On to world news. A car has plunged through a pedestrian area in the western German city of Trier, killing five people, including a nine-week-old baby girl, police say. The driver, a 51-year-old local man, has been arrested. The prosecutor said the suspect had drunk a significant amount of alcohol. Authorities say they were not working on the assumption that the accident was politically or religiously motivated. The city's mayor described the scene as horrible. Witnesses said people screamed in panic and some were thrown in the air by an SUV traveling at a high speed in Trier's Botrese and Simonstre streets towards the city's famous Roman gate, the Porta Negra. That's in Germany. In sports, Uganda's under-20 football team, the Hippos, are set to take on Tanzania today in the finals of the SEKAFA under-20 tournament. This game kicks off at 3 p.m. local time or East African Standard Time. Uganda defeated Kenya by 3-1 to reach the finals, while Tanzania beat South Sudan by 2-0. Hippos head coach Molly Viekwaso says they know what Tanzania can possess and have enough in their armory to defeat them at their home turf.
I think it's a good take. We are going to play a team which is stubborn. They are well built. They have the height and the size. We need to be very, very positive and knowing what we're going to do. The most important thing is not to play near their bodies because they are bigger than us. We need to be quick, we need to be swift, we need to be agile, and all in all, we need to possess the ball so well to see that we maintain or we have the most advantage of the day. Once we do that perfectly, I think we shall be victorious.
And that's the latest XFM News.
XFM News on point.